We are going to begin this subject with the quote of famous Einstein, in which he stressed that imagination is most important thing. Wave-particle duality is the concept in quantum mechanics that every particle or quantum entity may be described as either a particle or a wave. Albert Einstein proposed the wave-particle theory of electromagnetic radiation. This theory states that electromagnetic energy is released in discrete packets of energy, now called as photons, that act like waves. After Einstein presented his theory, scientists found evidence to support it. Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. Today we are going to discuss about the basics of electromagnetic field. We are going to explore this subject in three dimensions. In this session, we are going to discuss the types of waves and applications of electromagnetic fields. Mobile phones communicate by transmitting radio waves through a network of fixed antennas called base stations. Radio frequency waves are electromagnetic fields. We have defined electromagnetic theory as the discipline where the study of charges in rest and motion is involved. Charge is a single point. We can refer antenna as the source of force, and charges are as the destination of force. So this can be resembled to the antenna who applies some kind of force on the mobile phones. So same thing we have to study in this subject. So let us continue with this subject. It's all about the strength of electromagnetic radiation what we get on the mobile phone. Sometimes we get less signal, sometimes we get more signal. What is meaning of this less signal or more signal? Less signal or less strength means we have weak electric field intensity and weak magnetic field intensity combinedly reaching out to our mobile phone. Now these electromagnetic waves have a particular frequency. Frequency may have a higher value or lower value. For low frequency, there will be very lengthy waves. Those are called as radio waves. High frequency constitute the continuous frequencies, continuous motion of a wave in less time. For example, everything will have particular frequency, either it is sound wave or transverse wave. Electromagnetic waves are transverse wave. But if we take example of a violin string where a note A is used, then that particular note A will have 440 vibrations in 1 second. That means its frequency is 440 hertz. What wave we are considering here for study is freezed in time. That means we are not showing continuously moving wave, but wave moves continuously with respect to time. It moves across a time axis continuously. The wave in motion never stops at one place. It is a continuous motion. And what are the parts of electromagnetic wave? The total electromagnetic wave will have one electric field intensity component and one magnetic field intensity component, and they move in the direction of propagation. That is the direction of journey of our wave from one place to another place, from one country to another country, or wherever we wish to communicate using our mobile phone. This particular speed is given by 2.99 into 10 to the power meter inverse second. That is the speed of light in vacuum. This one we have to remember. All the waves, either it is light wave or any other electromagnetic wave, they will have this constant speed, but in some ideal condition where we are considering vacuum. When we consider vacuum, there won't be any decay in the wave. It is a continuous wave. But when we consider practical scenario, we have to consider various parameters. Now, one more important thing we have to understand about the waves, that it will have a maximum peak value. It will be called as amplitude. Now, if we see on this particular place where value of electric field intensity is highest, so this is representing the amplitude of electric field intensity. Similarly, on horizontal plane, we can see there is amplitude of H, that is the maximum value of magnetic field intensity. One more thing you can observe, that whenever there is peak value of electric field intensity, at the same time there is a peak value of magnetic field intensity, and both of them are perpendicular to each other. And the third thing you have to remember, that these two are perpendicular to each other, as well as they are perpendicular to the direction of journey or direction of propagation. So these are always perpendicular to each other. Now, when amplitude goes to, it starts from zero, then amplitude keeps on increasing to maximum level. Again, it go back to zero. At one particular point, E and H both become zero, and again their journey start towards the peak value. Like this, a wave continuously keep on moving in space. It is not static. We are freezing it for understanding purpose. So frequency may be lower frequency or higher frequency. Other parts of this wave constitute crest and trough. So crest is the height of our wave. We can consider height of wave as our crest, the peak value, maximum peak value towards positive direction. In negative direction, the maximum peak value is considered as trough. So one wavelength is considered between a trough to trough or crest to crest. That means this wave will have one crest here, that is the positive peak point. And again, it is starting from this place and going up to this maximum value of positive wave. That means this one is nothing but wavelength lambda. We represent it with lambda. So either crest to crest we can consider as wavelength, or from trough to trough, or simply we can start from 0 to 0. So from this particular point, from this 0, wave is starting, it is going to top, again 0, then next negative cycle, again it is going to peak and 0. This is also considered as one wavelength, that is lambda. That is the length of a wave. How we calculate for anything, we calculate it with respect to length, how lengthy is object. So here we are calculating wave in terms of length, so it will be calculated in meters. Now speed, that is nothing but meter per second, is closely related with wavelength and frequency. It is given by frequency into wavelength. Let us have more insight about frequency and wavelength. Now here we can see a wave which is traveling with respect to time. The arrow is showing the time axis. Now the frequency is the number of cycles appearing in 1 second, and the complete one wave is given by time period. The total time taken by one cycle to complete is given by capital T. Say from this zero to this zero, there will be one time period T. It is also called as wave period. So this distance will have, say, one oscillation, right? So this one oscillation frequency is number of oscillations per second. How many oscillations are there? So from this peak to this peak, this is called as the wave period or time period. So this is 1 upon f. These are inversely proportional. If frequency goes up, then this time period goes down. Let us see how it happens on with respect to time. Now in this example, let us imagine that in 1 second we are getting this one time period, one cycle in 1 second. So what will be the frequency of this wave with respect to time? It will be 1 hertz. That means one cycle is traveling in 1 second. Now if we increase it, if we get 2 cycles in 1 second in the same time, that means frequency is increased. Now we have 2 time periods, 2 waves, 2 oscillations in 1 second. So what will be the frequency? It will be 2 hertz. So as these number of oscillations increases in 1 second, the frequency also increases and time decreases to complete the oscillation. So here we can see how many are there, how many oscillations are there. This one, this second, this is third, and then fourth. That means in 1 second the frequency is increased, number of oscillations are increased. So in 1 second here, if we have four oscillations, we are calling it as 4 cycles per second, that is 4 hertz. So if we get 400 cycles, then we'll call it as we'll say that frequency is 400 hertz. That is simple meaning of hertz. Now let us see in the moving object. Say we are starting from 0 second and between 1 second. So the wave will travel from one place to another place. So in this particular motion we can calculate how many waves have traveled in 1 second. Those many number of oscillations will be considered as the frequency of that wave. So now let us check out one example where speed of light is associated with wavelength and frequency. Say we have to find out, specify the frequency, wavelength and speed in a vacuum of each of the types of electromagnetic radiation listed below. So we have 2 things here. One is blue light, whose lambda is given, that is 500 nanometer. You can see this is very short wave for blue green light in nanometers, not even meter. Nano means it's a very very small wavelength of wave. This is light wave, part of the light in blue green. And second one, we can find out the FM radio transmission. Frequency is given here. Frequency is 91.5 megahertz. We get various songs or radio channels at various frequencies. You set the frequency and you get different channels. So if we know the frequency, we can find out the speed of wave and we can find out the length of that particular wave. So let us check out one example. So we have formula, the relation between speed of light or speed of wave will be equal to lambda f. Speed of light and speed of all the waves in vacuum will be same, that is 2.998 into 10 to the power 8 meter inverse second. So we can use this relation to find out. So from the from this equation we can say frequency is equal to speed by lambda. So here we have speed constant speed 2.998, and blue green light lambda is given, it is 500 into 10 to the power minus 9 nanometers. This is the wavelength. So we can find out the frequency. So what will be the frequency after solving this? We will get 6 into 10 to the power 14 meter inverse second. Inverse second is the unit for this particular hertz. So this is the frequency of this blue green light. Now your work is to calculate frequency of FM radio transmission and post it in the comment for today's assignment. Now let us discuss about the spectrum and different frequencies in the spectrum. So now let us discuss the electromagnetic range. Electromagnetic spectrum have a wide range. It starts from radio to gamma ray. We have to remember that there are total 7 ranges. We are dividing it. First one is radio, second one microwave, third infrared, visible, ultraviolet, x-ray and gamma ray. For radio will have very low frequency. They have at the lower side of frequency. From lower frequency to higher frequency we have very wide range of frequencies. That is what we are dividing. Our mobile signals will lie between next to radio waves and before microwave. We have visible light spectrum also. Similarly we have different kind of spectrum ranges. Total 7 ranges we have to remember. Here it goes like this, our wave from there we can see their wavelength is increasing, but frequency is very low. This is very low frequency. And here we can see that the wavelength is decreasing, but frequency is very fast. In less time, more number of waves are traveling. For visible light, we have fixed colors. What are those fixed colors? Those fixed colors are from the rainbow colors. All of us know the rainbow colors. What are rainbow colors? In rainbow colors, we have 7 colors, which are red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. So these are visible. We can see them. But other waves we cannot see. But other waves applications we use, like in mobile application or microwave or X-rays, cameras, these are very, very, very common rays we are using in day-to-day life. We read about them in medical applications or some gadgets. Now let us discuss one more time what is exactly low frequency looks like. It may start at particular place, say in one country, at one particular moment. Say it is starting in India, and the wave in one oscillation it may reach to another country, say China. That means my wave is starting in India and one is reaching in China. Example of low frequency, because it is not continuously moving in less time. But wavelength is very large, in kilometers, in hundreds and thousands of kilometers. But when we talk about high frequency, what we get? We get continuous waves. There will be many, many waves in the same duration. This is high frequency. So I hope low frequency, high frequency concept is clear. So what we are doing here? We are having one transmitter, one receiver, and all of them are connected with a field. Field is electric field and magnetic field, where electric and magnetic forces are working together. All of them are vectors. So we have to study these fields. They are vectors, and we have to study them in 3D space. This is nothing but part of our study of subject. Now we can take another example to understand the transverse wave. Electromagnetic waves are transverse wave. That means their motion is always perpendicular to the direction of motion. So suppose you are holding one rope at one end and another end. You are tying one end to one place and keeping another end open in your hand, and you are just making movements of your hand to create waves. So when this movement is transverse movement, we get the negative peak, that is trough, we get positive peak, that is crest, and continuously we can create the waves. This wave will travel from this place to next place until the end of this particular rope, right? So similarly, in electromagnetic field, we'll have two waves. Electric field intensity, say if we are considering on the vertical plane, it will be ocean like wave like this. Then H, that is magnetic field, will have snake like movement, that will be like this on the ground, horizontal ground. Like these two waves we have to study. So all these fields we have to study, we have to combine them with Maxwell's equations. Maxwell's, what he did earlier, earlier equations were formed by previous scientists like Gauss and Ampere. He compiled them at one place and he deducted them for one place. So we will see the application related to this particular subject, and whatever applications we are not using, that we will omit. So Maxwell's equations are given by electrostatic and magnetostatic. That means they are not changing with respect to time. So time component is zero. The changing time component is zero. After this, combination of all these fields will be electromagnetic waves. They are not static, they are dynamic, changing with respect to time. Then we have to connect it with transmission line theory. Transmission line theory will give us the detail how field theory is connected with the circuit theory. So we have to see the circuit theory and field theory combination. This is one of the application of electromagnetic fields. It uses various circuit theory laws like Kirchhoff's law. Then we have different waves moving in space. Now we will see how these waves behave when they come across. We may get a question that I am also calling on the mobile phone and my friend is also calling on the mobile phone. Do these waves strike with each other and how these waves behave when they come across with another wave? Let us take this diagram into 3D mode and discuss it. If two waves are in phase, then they get combined and the resultant wave becomes larger. For example, we have two waves here, one with amplitude A1 and another one with amplitude A2. Both of them are in phase. That means their starting point and ending points are same. That means they are in phase. So if these two in phase waves overlap with each other, then they will get combined. Here we can see that the two waves A1 and A2, as they are in phase, they get added and the resultant wave amplitude increases as shown in this figure. Now if we consider another wave B1 and B2, which are out of phase with each other, if we combine them, then both the waves will be subtracted from each other. So the resultant wave will be lesser than the original waves. So here we can see when we have waves in phase, they will get added. If the wave is out of phase, then they will get subtracted. Now we have seen the oscillations, like antenna is sending the signals and the receiver is receiving the signals, receiver is also having antenna. But how we get these oscillations? We are talking about transverse waves, the sinusoidal waves. So the simple example to get these waves is by using tank circuit. Tank circuit is a simple circuit which uses inductor and capacitor. Ideally, it continuously generates the wave. How it works? Only for once, we have to charge the capacitor. And then what he will do? Once he is charged, we will remove the supply. Then this capacitor, once fully charged, he will discharge himself through the inductor. Then inductor will charge. By the time, capacitor will discharge. Now, inductor is charged. Then he will discharge himself through capacitor. Then capacitor will charge and the inductor will be discharged. And this cycle will be continuously going on. So this change in this particular polarity will generate the waves, like sinusoidal waves. Those are called as oscillations. This circuit creating this oscillation is called as tank circuit. So tank circuit can be used in the antennas where we will have push switch. So once we close it, then we will remove it. There will be one capacitor, one inductor, and they will continuously charge, discharge and create the oscillation, the waves. Waves will be transmitted in air. But when we are talking about practical waves, those will not be continuous. They will not have same amplitude all the time because they are no more ideal. In practical scenario, there will be various losses, there are various observations. So the wave can have two different categories. One will be uniform plane wave and another one will be non-uniform plane wave. So uniform plane wave will have same amplitude all the time. This will be ideal wave. Normally when we consider a vacuum, or for mathematical purpose, we always consider uniform plane wave. But what will be the practical wave? Practical wave will be non-uniform. After time and after distance, with respect to time and distance, the amplitude will decrease for this particular wave continuously. So this is the practical wave. But for mathematical purpose, we consider ideal wave, where we consider uniform plane wave. It is considered, it is called as UPW. So these uniform plane waves are considered for the study purpose. So here we get an antenna, simple antenna, where we get DC supply. Once we push button and then again open, so there will be transmission of the wave signal across the antenna. Two open wires can also be considered as antenna. Wherever there is end of wire, where this current and voltage will go, this current and voltage will get converted into field parameters in terms of electromagnetic wave. So there will be virtual capacitance C and virtual inductance across the wires. The conductor will be considered as the conducting mediums. There will be virtual inductors and there will be virtual capacitance. It will generate the electric field across this particular motion, and it travels with respect to speed of time. So we may have polarization. We can create horizontal and vertical waves by using appropriate generator. In horizontal line or vertical line, if we place the source, according to that we can create the polarized wave, either vertical and horizontal. At the core of everything lies is a charge. We may have two type of charges. Charge is represented by Q. It may be positive charge, it may be negative charge. At basis of everything what we are studying here lies a charge. When a charge moves, we get some kind of dynamic condition, and it is the one on whom we are for applying the force, or it is the one who is applying the force. This small particle, for example electron, if we zoom it, it is like a big sphere, like a sun emits energy in all the direction. Similarly, charges emit forces in all the direction. It gives rise to the question whether the electromagnetic waves are wave motion or particle or photon motion. So they are considered as wave motion when it is coming from a charge. If there are multiple charges, what is current? Current is nothing but flow of charges or number of charges. Always these charges generate electric field intensity to the perpendicular to the charge itself. From every place there will be emission of electric field intensity, which will constitute a wave motion. But similarly, the concept can be explained by the photon. It is called as wave particle duality. That means that behavior of a light or any wave can be explained by using the wave motion or the photon motion. So that is nothing but the wave particle duality. So this energy associated with photon is given by Max Planck. So it is also called as Planck's rule, where it is defined as energy equal to hv, where h is Planck's constant. Its value is 6.6262 into 10 to the power minus 34 joules second. Now let us briefly discuss about transmission lines, which is application of electromagnetic waves. Transmission line is a cable which is designed to conduct electromagnetic waves in a contained manner. Transmission lines are shown here with the arrows. These lines are used for the transmission of electrical power from generating substation to the various distribution units. It transmits the wave of voltage and current from one end to another end. These lines are made up of conductor having same cross-sectional area along the line. All of you must have seen such kind of transmission lines around us. These are placed from cities to cities. In next session, we will continue with the types of waves and the differences between circuit and field theory. We will also see few more applications of electromagnetic fields. Till then, have a good day.